What is a set? What is the purpose of a set? Set is a collection of similar elements. List is also a collection of similar elements. Set is also a collection of similar elements. Set can increase or decrease based on runtime requirement. The size of the set can increase or decrease based on runtime requirement. Set will not accept duplicate events. List will accept duplicate events. Set will not maintain insertion order. The order which we are inserting, in the same order the elements will not be same. Set will not maintain insertion order. List will maintain insertion order. As simple as that. So what was that set? Set is a collection of similar elements. Size of the set grow or decrease based on runtime requirement. Size of the set can grow or decrease based on runtime requirement. Set will not accept duplicate element. Set will not maintain insertion order. Set is a collection of similar elements. The size of the set can grow or decrease based on runtime requirement. Set will not accept a duplicate element. Set will not maintain insertion order. Right. Syntax. Set of data type. Set of data type, set type. Set of data type, set type. Means equal to set of data type. Data type can be primitive. Data type can be a primitive data type or it can be non-primitive data type. Data type can be a primitive or non-primitive. This is how we have created. Now we have some predefined methods to insert the elements or work on the elements. So let's take some examples. Create a set to store opportunities. 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 Create a set to store cases. Create a set to store cases. Next, create a set to store city names. Create a set to store city names. Create a set to store city names. So it is going to be set of string city. Create a set to store salaries. Create a set to store salaries. So basically, when do you go for string? When do you go for list? When do you go for set? If I want to maintain a duplicate values, there is a possibility that duplicate values may come list. There is no possibility that duplicate values will come. It is a set. List, set. If you feel there is a possibility of getting a duplicate values, it is a. If you feel it's a. If you feel there is a possibility of getting a duplicate values, list. If you feel that there is no possibility of getting a duplicate value, I don't want a duplicate value, then I have to go for set. List is for accepting the duplicates. Set is for not accepting the duplicates. Okay. Let us see the methods. First method. This method will add new element. This method will add a new element to the set. So when I add it, there is no guarantee that the elements will be stored like this only. See. This is the set. Add the elements to the set. Now when you add it, there is no guarantee the elements will be saved like this. Will be saved like this also. There is no guarantee the order in which we are inserted, in the order, same order, they will be saved. There is no guarantee that the elements will be like 70, 20, 90. It can be saved in any order. We cannot guarantee that. I hope you are good with this. Okay. Next we have add all. This method will add list of elements This method will add list or set to the existing set. So we have at all, adding the values of list at all. If you want to add a list to a set, if you want to add list to a set, if you want to add a list to a set, what is the value of this? Add all. This will add group of elements to the set. If you want to add existing set to a set, or if you want to add a list to a set, we use add all. Right, boss? Then, in the list, if you want to remove, how do you remove? Remove of index. When I say remove to, remove the element from the index. When I say remove 4, remove the element from the index 4. But in the set, straight away we give remove element. This will remove the element from the set. This will remove the element from the set. Remove element. This will remove the element from the set. Remove element. This will remove element from the set. If you want to straight away give, then how do you give it? Ages dot So, we are straight away removing the elements. We are straight away removing the elements. We are straight away removing the elements. Was that system dot debug ages? System dot debug ages. System dot debug ages. What is the value we got? 20 and 40. So what is this? Add, add all, remove. If you want to remove a group of elements, remove all. Set from the this will remove set from the set or list from the set. Age is equal to then I'm giving here set of integer. This is how we got it. So, what do you want to remove? Ages dot remove all. So remove all the elements which are in values. Let us say there is a 88 also. Remove all the elements from the values. Remove all the values from the ages. Remove all the values from the ages. We give it. What happened? We are going to have 10, 30, 80. So remove the elements. Whatever the values we have, remove these set values from the ages. Remove all the elements which are in values from the ages. Now 88 is there. It is not there. If in case if the element is there, remove it. Remove single element, remove a list of element. Remove single element, remove a list of elements. Then again we have contains element. This method will return true if the set contains the given element. We had here. It is not contained. Is dot contains. So it verifies whether the set contains this element. If the set is containing the element called 10, if the set has a value called 10, it will give you true, otherwise it will give you false. Contains element. Verify whether the set contains the given element or not. Verifies whether the set contains given element or not. Set contains element. Contains all. Then true. If the set contains this method will return true if the set contains all the elements in the list. This method will return true if the set contains all the elements in the list or set. Then we have boolean b equal to ages dot contains all if ages contains all the values, all the elements in the values, if ages contain all the elements in the value, that is going to be written you true. We have here 10, 30, 50, 2. Now we are verifying a single element there. We are verifying a group of elements here. Single element, group of element. Single element, group of element. Single element, group of element. I hope you are good with this. Yes, so what we have? We have add, add all. Remove, remove all. Contains, contains all. Right, boss? I hope the mother name itself can be more
there.
Yes.
Hello, Satish. Can you please explain the last example once again? Contains all.
If the set contains all the elements given in this set. Now, if ages contain all the elements in the values, it is going to give you true. Contains 10. If 10 is there in the set, it is giving. Contains all values. If the set contains 10, 30, 50, it is going to give you true. If you want to check whether a particular element is there or not, contains. You want to check whether all the elements in the list are there in the set, or all the elements in the set are there in the set, we use contains all. You want to check one element, contains. You want to check a group of element, contains all. I hope you are good.
Yeah, got it. Thank you.
Next.
So, Satish, so that means we can also check in a set whether a list of elements are present or not.
Yes, obviously, right? Elements in the list are set. Right. Now, what we have? Size. What was the size? This will written count of number of elements in the set. Count of number of elements in the set. And I have integer size equal to. Then we can use some basic set here. When I give size, you see 6. Similarly, we have the rest of the elements, common methods. What this will do? This will remove all the elements it will remove all the elements from the set. When I have example, then I have is empty. This will return true if the set is empty. This will return true if the set is empty. This is what we have got. So we had add, add all, remove, remove all, contains, contains all, size, clear, is empty. Then we have retain all. When you say return all, only common elements will be coming, rest of the elements will be deleted. When you say remove, whatever the common elements are there, they are removed, rest of the elements will be left. When you say retain, only common elements will come, rest of the elements are deleted. When I say remove, what happened? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, remove. Whatever the common elements are there, they are removed. So 1, 2 is removed, 3 is left out. When I say retain, what is the common elements we have? 1, 2. Only the common elements in two sets will be given to you. If I say delete, if I say remove, then if I say one dot remove all, what happened? Whichever the common elements are there, they are removed. 10 is removed, 20 is removed. Now what is the value of 1? The same thing if I say one dot retain all, return all 2. Now in both the things, what is common? 10 and 20 is common. When you give system.debug, only 10 and 20 is clear. Did you get my point? When you say delete, whichever the elements are common, they are deleted. 1 dot remove all 2. Whatever the common elements are there in 1 and 2, they are deleted. When I say 1 dot retain all 2, whichever the common elements are there, only they are left, remaining are deleted from the set. I hope you are good with this. People have followed this point. So what we have? Retain all. Retain all. In both the sets, whatever the common elements are there, or both the list, whatever the, in the set and the list, common elements. Set and set, common elements. Whenever I say group, we are referring to set as well as list. Okay. So retain all. This is store the common elements, remove the rest of them. Same story here, what I have given. A is not retain all. So, system dot debug ages. What is the common elements in both the things? 20, 30, 20, 50. Rest of the elements are removed. I hope you got the basic idea about this method. Basic. Add, add all, remove, remove all, contain, contain all, retain, size is empty, right? Size is empty, and we have seen sorting technique. Do you have any sorting technique here? There is no sorting technique in the set because the elements are not inserted in the proper order. There is no predefined method for sorting. If you want to sort the elements, you need to write your own custom logic. If you want to sort the elements, you need to write your own custom logic. I hope you are good with this. Okay. Now let us take a combination of list and set. Now, while taking a list, I can display list of elements in the VF page with the page block table. But I cannot display set of elements in the page block table. If you want to use a page block table, data list, repeat, all these four will support only list. So generally, if you want to display a group of elements, what we do? We go with a page block table, data list, repeat. Now, this is only used to display a list of elements or map of elements, but it will not support set. List and map both are supported. List and map both are supported, but set is not supported. Did you get my point? If you want to display a group of elements in the VF page, it has to be either a set or a map. So, in case you want to display this in the VF page, what should I do? Convert the set into list, then do it. Okay. Now, look at the point. I have a list of entities. List of integer. List of integer age is equal to new list of integer. I want to convert, I can also convert integer. Well, is equal to. Straight away, what it does? Create a set with all the values in the list. Similarly, vice versa. If you want to create a list, we can create list and set straight away. So at the time of creating the list itself, if you have value of a set, straight away give the value of a set, automatically that set will be converted into list. I told you very clearly, set will not accept duplicate values, right? I told very clearly, set will not accept duplicate value. But if you are entering a duplicate value, then what will happen? I told set will not accept duplicate value, but if you are entering a duplicate value, what will happen? What will happen?
Read into one, read as one.
Now, simply, if you want to, so, once again, what was the point I was discussing? Was, if you want to convert list into set, if you want to convert the list into set, what we are doing? Straight away, I am giving the elements here. Now, if there is a duplicate element, because the list has a duplicate values. When you are converting them to set, what will happen? Boss, there is no harm. If duplicate values are there, only latest value will be kept, old value will be removed. So if you have a duplicate values, what will happen? It will remove the old values and set the new values. I hope you are clear with this. Yes. Now, let us go to the next one. Let us take a quick example. Everyone listen here. Now, this is list. What is the name of the list?
List of.
We are having a list here. In the list we have this value. This is the name of the list. In the list we have the following values. Now get me all the unique values of account names. Get me all the unique names of account names. Get me all the unique, okay, unique phone numbers. Get me all the unique industries. Get me the names of the account. Get me the names, okay, get me the phone numbers. Get me the industries. Now, when I say get me the name, I don't want the duplicates. When I say get me the industry, I don't want the duplicates. Now, write the code. Now, don't create the list. Assume that list is already there. Assume that the list is already there. What is the name of the list? Accounts. Okay. Fetch account names. Complete. Then what will you do? How do you refer to the elements in the set, boss? How do you refer to the element in the set? For account A, take one by one account, put the name in the set. Put the name in the set. Fetch the account names from the list and put them in a set.
Satish, I have a question.
Yes.
In the 16th point, you have created a list and you have assigned memory with new keyword. But I am your old student, so I have gone through the other piece of code. So, at times, what you have done is you have created list of accounts and directly a SQL query is assigned to it instead of assigning new memory to it.
See, Baba, when you're writing a query, SQL query will give you data, right? Where is the data saved?
Right, in the list. But with the new keyword, you need to first assign the memory, right, Satish?
Hold for a minute. You're not allowing me to speak. When you write a SQL query, you're getting a data. Where is the data saved? Without memory, the data will come to you. Now, list will refer to, this is referring to some instance of a memory. So you are creating a memory. In the SQL query, this is already created by the query. The query is what this is creating? Creating a memory and putting the data. When you write a SQL query, it has already created the memory and it is putting the data which you are referring with the list.
Okay. Got that, Satish. Thank you.
So yeah, everyone has done this first point. What we do? For first I want to take it. Set of names equal to new set of accounts. So what I was doing, names dot add. Let us go to the next one. Please mute your mic. Fetch all the industry names. Fetch all the industry names, put them in a set. Thank you.
Satish, I have gone through your one of the example where the example refers to list, set, map, all the concepts. Now the question is, how do I master it? Like, when do we use list? When do we use set? I know map to certain extent, but when it comes to list and set.
If you don't want a duplicate set, you want duplicate list. As simple as that. You don't want the duplicates set. You want duplicates list. One single point. Now you decide. Now I told fetch all the index names and put them in a set. Now you want to fetch banking, energy. Let us say it is also energy. You want to fetch banking, energy, energy. Go for list. You want to fetch banking and energy? Go for set. Now you want to take the duplicate or don't want to take the duplicate? That's what we'll decide, list or set. Straight away point. If you don't want the duplicate, now I want to know the name of the industries. Banking, energy is enough. But you want, no, you want to store every value of the industry. That becomes banking, energy, energy. Then I have to go for list. So you want to store duplicate? List. Don't want to have a duplicate, one entry is enough, go for set. There is no complexity between these topics. Straight away point. List, duplicate, set, no duplicates. As simple as that. Now, when should you use? Again, according to your requirement. Do you want a duplicate to be stored separately? Then list. That depends upon your requirement again. Now, conceptually, what is it? Duplicate or without duplicate? Whether you want to take a duplicate or not, you have to decide it. I hope you are good. Okay. Then removing, when you want to remove a particular element, in the set we have very concept, remove the element directly. In the list, we have to find out the index. So quick removal, based on the element you want to remove, set. Based on the index you want to remove, list. Right? Industries dot add a dot. I hope you are good with this. Okay. This is how we have created. So let us go to the next example. The name of the list is contacts. Now get me all the contacts whose resource is email, put them in a set. Get me all the contacts whose resource is email, put them in a set. Get me all the contacts whose lead source is email, put them in a set. So do this. So how do you create that? Then what we do? Contacts, see contacts. If C dot lead source equal to email, if the lead source equal to email, then put them in a once dot. Take every contact, verify that the lead source equal to email, and add them to the set. Add them to the set because we already have a method called add. Now, contact C contacts. We are adding names dot. So I can make a string here. Get me all the phone numbers and put them in a set. This is how we created. I hope you are good with this. Clear for everyone? Clear, boss? Now, basically, what we are doing, trying to exercise the data. Now, let us take one quick example. Create a set. Create a set. Create a set. Create a set which will store. Create a set which will store city names. Create a set which will store city names. Create a set which will store city names. Add Hyderabad. Create a set which will store add Hyderabad. Add Chennai, add Bangalore, add Pune, remove Bangalore, add Chennai, add Chennai. Add Chennai. Print the values. Tell me what is the output of it.
Sir, I have a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
As we discussed, set doesn't accept duplicate values. Okay. In the previous example, last there are two last names with the word M.
What
okay.
I told.
So,
if you give a duplicate value, old value will be replaced with new value. It will not throw any error message. The old value will be replaced with a new value. It will not accept any. It will not throw any error message. If you give a duplicate value, it will not throw any error. The old value will be replaced with a new value.
Hello, sir.
Now, what is the output of this? What is the output of this? So we are going to have Hyderabad, Chennai. So here we are going to have Hyderabad, Chennai, Bangalore. Remove Bangalore. So we are going to get Hyderabad, Chennai. Remove Chennai, Hyderabad. Sorry. Add Chennai. So what happened? Add Chennai. Because it's a duplicate. Old value is replaced with a new value. Finally, what is the output we are going to get? Hyderabad, Chennai. Next we have create a set. Remove. Find the size. Find the size. Clear all the limits. Write the code for this. Write the code for this. Yes, go ahead. Somebody from online. What is your query?
Sir, from the above in the second example, when we are adding the list to the other list, can we use add all method?
We can do it. But yeah. I'm not adding every element here, right?
I'm adding. Oh, yeah, we are not adding every element. Yeah.
That's the reason I have not used add all.
Okay, thank you.
Then what happened? Create a list. Then how do you remove all the elements? Remove all. What is left out? Size of the list. Clear all the elements. Size of the list. Clear all the elements. Right, boss. Everyone is good with this structure? So few methods are clear. Okay. Clear for everyone? Now, once again, when do you go for list? What is the difference that you find between list and set? List will accept duplicate elements. List will maintain insertion order. So, look at the point, boss. If you are going for a list or a set, basically we are storing the data as one group. We are storing the data as one group. But if you want to find out a particular element from the list, it's a difficult task for you. I have 100 records in the list. When you have 100 records in the list, when you want to identify a particular account, how do you do that? You have stored 100 records. You have stored 100 records. Let us say you wrote a SQL query. 30,000 records came. Out of that 30,000 records, I want to choose all those accounts. Okay, I want to choose a particular account. How do you retrieve? If you want to retrieve a particular element, it is a very difficult task. We are storing a group of element. On the group, if you want to apply a logic, list is a good. Now, I want to store a group of elements, but I should not contain any duplicate. Set is good. But if it is a concept of retrieving the data, you want to take a particular element. Now and then, I have a group. Boss, give me that record. Use the logic. Give me this value. Use the logic. Like that, you want to handpick one or two records randomly as per your business requirement. Then set and list is not a good choice. Now let us say, now if you give me ID, based on the ID, I want to get the record. I have a list of records. If you give me ID of the record, based on the ID, I want to retrieve the record. Then list is not a good option. Because where is that ID? I have to go through every record and find where is that ID. Based on the phone number, I want to retrieve the records. Then how do you find? I have to write a loop. Now, if you look at this, every time I write a loop, take every element. Okay, lead source is email or not, take it. So, if you want to handpick one or two specific records every time as per the requirement, it is very difficult. List and set are very suitable concepts for holding the large amount of data. And you want to apply a similar category of operation on every element, then list and set are very good. But when you want to retrieve the data, I want to retrieve a particular record, then list and set is not suitable. We have to go for map. We have to go for a concept called map. List is a collection of similar elements. Set, collection of similar elements. List accept a duplicate. Set will not accept a duplicate. If you look at add, same thing. But if you look at remove, in the list we are going to remove based on index. Remove element at first position. In the set we say remove 20, remove particular element. Straight away if you give element, that will be deleted. So, if it is a list, what should I do? Write a for loop, find out at what position the element is, then say remove this element. In the set is not like that. When you want to remove, straight away give the value, it will be removed. So, if you are frequently performing, if your aim is to store the data, remove the data frequently, then set is a good option. You don't want to have a duplicate, set is an option. You don't want to go for duplicate, set is a good option. And if after storing, your frequently performed operation is delete. After storing, if your frequently performed operation is delete, again, set is a good option. But when you go to list, you want to accept a duplicate. You want to accept a duplicate. You want to go for a sorting technique. That is a list. Duplicates, list. Non-duplicates, set. As simple as that point. I hope you are clear. And both of them are not suitable for picking up a particular record. Now, I have 10 records. Take every record, run the logic. Yes, list and set are good. I have 1000 records, okay, take a loop, take one by one record, apply a condition, list and set are good. No, my frequent operation is picking up a record and using in my logic, it is not good. So, list and set are very good for storing the data and performing the operation on every record. If you want to retrieve the record whenever you want, it is not a good option. I hope you are good. There is a reason why we are going for map concept. People are good, right? List and set are good for what? storing the data, not for retrieving the data. Store group of record, perform same operation on group. Okay, take a group of record, perform the same operation on the group, it is listened set. Right boss, retrieving, if your logic is you store the data and out of this data as per your requirement you want to pick up one record, then listened set are not good because every time you have to run a loop. Suppose the record what you are searching is in the last position, you have 30,000 records, the record what you are searching, if it is in the last position, what will happen? Loop will run for 30,000 times. It is going to decrease my performance because I cannot pick up the record straight away. Can you pick a particular record straight away? No, it is not possible. If my record is in 30,000 record, I have to write a loop, run the loop for 30,000 times, then only I find my record. So we require some better solution for this. That solution is what? Map. I hope you got the drawback of this. If it is a listed set, what should I do? Write a loop, search for the condition, get the record. But I want better solution from this. That is solution is, what is that solution? Map. I hope you are good. We'll see that map in the next class. So try to be here by